If you use the Godot engine, though, you probably already heard about signals. They're one of the best and most intuitive features in Godot. They allow nodes to tell other nodes what just happened without worrying about the path it takes to get to them. They're really useful, and if you want to learn how to make your code path independent, just sit back, relax, and don't forget that I make videos like this all the time, so subscribe if you're into stuff like that. And let me show you how easy they are to use. So in my last video, I made the camera track the player using an anchor node. But the script that I wrote for that was path dependent, meaning that if the anchor or the player were to be moved out of their current path, it wouldn't work anymore. To fix this, all we have to do is connect a signal from the player to the anchor. To do that, we simply declare a signal in the player script. Then click on the player node and go to the node tab. There you'll see all the signals that the node can emit. And would you look at that, it's a signal we just created. Now click on the signal and you should see something like this. Don't panic, it just means you're doing everything absolutely correct. Then just head over to the node that you want to pass the signal to, the target node. You can leave the default function that Godot will create for you, or you can change it to whatever you like. Then hit connect. And there you go, we're all set. Now to actually send a signal. Just head back to the player script, then on the ready function, call the emit signal function, which is used to emit signals, and pass in the arguments that it needs. The first argument is the name of the signal you would like to emit. Any arguments after that are the variables you might want to pass into the receiving end, the target function. We'll be passing in our current class instance, the node that we're currently scripting, which is basically what self means. Then in the target function, in the target node, we'll need to create a variable that will accept what we're passing in from the incoming signal. If you don't do this, you'll get an error, which basically means that the argument being passed in from the incoming signal doesn't have a corresponding variable in the target function. When you're done with that, then we can just clear the path we made in our last video and make the player in our function equal to the player that we're tracking. Now, because tracking is something that we're going to be doing as soon as the game starts, we won't want anything to start until the signal has been sent. Just create a variable called started. And right before your code for tracking, declare an if statement. Just type if started, then highlight your tracking code and make it an indent higher by pressing the tab button. The last thing you'd want to do is set started to true at the bottom of your target function. And now the player can be moved and reparented without breaking your code. Another very useful thing about signals is that one signal can be connected to multiple different nodes. This is very useful in my game because by pressing the tab button, the player can jump in and out of the map editor. But unfortunately, the code used to make this happen is path dependent. If only there was a way I could fix that. That's right, signals. So basically all I have to do is connect the start signal to the map node. And in the target function in the map node, set the player's map value to itself. Then in the player scripts, just make the map a normal variable. Now the player can be moved around and reparented and still be able to use the map. Signals can be connected to nodes that are not part of your scene tree through code. And it was used to make something like this happen. By parenting the bullets to a singleton instead of a node in the scene that the player is in, the bullets can move and spawn independent of the player's position and current scene. You can do this, or you can add the bullets as a child of the player and deal with this. After you've created a singleton, you'll notice that it's not part of your scene tree, and the only way to connect a signal to them is through code. First thing you'd want to do is create a target function in the singleton. So to connect the gun's shoot function to the singleton, all you have to do is use the connect function. Then type in the signal you would like to connect, then the name of the singleton or target scene, then the name of the target function that you've created. You can also connect signals to a node in your current scene through code using the same method. Now you can emit the signal and pass in the arguments that you'll need. And don't forget to put the corresponding variables at the target function in your singleton or target node. But what if for some reason you'd want to connect a singleton to a node? So for this example, I basically reverse gravity anytime there are no bullets in the room. To do this, I just made a signal in the singleton script. Then made some logic to check if there are any bullets that have been spawned, and for each case I emit a signal which passes a new value for gravity. To connect a signal from a singleton to a node, all I have to do is create a target function in that node, and on its ready function, name the singleton and then call the connect function in the singleton's class, then the signal in the singleton I would like to connect, then the target node and the target function. And just like that, they are connected. Lastly, I'd want to talk about the built-in signals in Godot. If you click on any node and head to the node tab, you should see some pre-made signals by Godot. You can hover your mouse over these signals and see exactly what they do. So for this example, I'll be making the player's gun start its cooldown right after the flash animation has been played. So on the animation player node, you should see a signal called animation finished. It basically emits a signal anytime the animation has been finished. Then you can just connect the signal to the gun. And on the target function, just start the cooldown timer. And on the timer's timeout, set the can shoot variable to be true. Then to make the bullets, I use an area 2D node. And they have a signal called body entered, which emits anytime a body is entered. So to make the bullets disappear when they hit the wall, I use the body entered signal and connected it to the area 2D. And on the target function, I use the Q3 function, which basically deletes the node. I hope this video helped you to understand what signals are, and if they didn't, I could always make a follow-up video to this. If it did though, don't forget to subscribe and comment what else you'd want me to teach you.